Has a writer ever wrote a bestseller in their first draft? Has an artist ever painted a masterpiece without preliminary drawings? It can happen, but typically for a project to succeed, you have to do a lot of planning. So why do engineers jump right into drafting in 3D software before having a good concept? The answer is the good ones don't. Part of a successful project is having a workable, well thought out concept. And sketching is a big part of developing great concepts. Engineers, they design things, they explain things, they build things, and best of all, they do cool things. To do cool things, we have to understand what we want to do. We have to develop concepts. Da Vinci had it right. He sketched out everything as a concept. This is a little arch bridge with truss elements, a little cable stay thing going on, little man on a horse on top of the bridge. Leonardo used this little sketch in the top corner for a concept for a bridge he wanted to build. He never got to build a bridge, but it was actually built based on that little sketch because all the elements were worked out in that sketch. Technical sketching is a big part of being an engineer. They solve the problems before they arise. The better the concept, the less chance of costly changes during construction. Changes equals money. And not money for me or you, but for the contractor that gets to do the change. The Big Dig was a project to improve the traffic conditions in Boston by building bridges, roads, and an underground tunnel of 8 to 10 lanes. And what happens on these mega projects? They take a long time to build, and they always go over budget. $2.6 billion up to $15 billion. Was that a good concept? Probably not. Imagine designing a building for a client, drafting the plans, and after construction begins, realizing you forgot bathrooms. It's one of the things when you start just going right into CAD to design things, you don't think of all the elements that you need to use. And changes in a CAD system after you've designed 40 floors is difficult to do. The John Hancock Tower in Boston. One of the issues they had were that the windows were falling out and crashing to the pavement hundreds of feet below. You can imagine this is not a good thing for pedestrians. They replaced all 10,000 windows at a cost of $5 million. Good concept? Probably not. The Tacoma Narrow Bridge. This is a famous bridge in engineering. It's swayed. They built it on the cheap, and what they learned from it, that they didn't have enough strength in the girders. You get the idea. Good concepts are necessary before you get into software. This is a bridge I designed. It's a three-span, and this picture shows the first stage before we knocked down the old truss bridge behind it. When I designed it, we did a lot of preliminary sketches to work out the aesthetics of the project, how the staging was going to work, just about everything we could before we committed it to CAD software. We worked on what kind of bridge should it be, a five-span, three-span, where should the piers end up, all sorts of things that we had to do preliminary design for. Here's a staging diagram. I did a really quick technical sketch showing the different stages and all the different kinds of loads that I had to worry about on the girders. If you're a structural engineer, you'll understand this. If the concept is not finalized, you're going to have to redo all your calculations if you make any major changes to the project. So technical sketching helps you come up with good concepts so you don't have to make changes further down the line. Once you get your concept done and you're satisfied, all the problems are worked out, then you can commit it to CAD and start your production drawings. And you're going to end up with a really beautiful bridge. Technical sketching is something that all designers should practice and use for brainstorming, concepts, teaching, and in general to better understand your design before beginning final production drawings. Better understanding equals less mistakes. Less mistakes equals less change orders. Change orders are where the contractor says to you, hey, there's a mistake here. It'll cost you 20% extra to get it changed. Less wasted money if you have less change orders. Once you have your final concept, then it's time to hit the 3D software and have some fun.